गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नोबल गैस एलिमेंट्स। सो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द टॉपिक, सो टू बी कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक, हियर ऑलरेडी देयर ज़ीनान कंपाउंड्स, ज़ीनान हैलाइड्स, ज़ीनान ऑक्साइड्स, ज़ीनान ऑक्सी हैलाइड्स। दीस आर ज़ीनान हैलाइड्स आर थ्री टाइप्स, HCF2, HCF4, HCF6 and oxides are two type, HCO3, HCO4. Oxy halides are three type, HCOF4, HCOF2, HCO2F2. Then today we discuss all noble gas elements. Now in this one, so the previous see again here HCO3. First we find oxidation state, X plus 3 into minus 2 equal to 0, X minus 6 equal to 0, X equal to 6. Its oxidation state is plus 6. Here plus 6 means 600 electron will be take place. So thus what is the electronic configuration? This one NH2 NP 6. So this is in a ground state. In S, it contains one or the two electron, and P contains 3 or the 6 electrons. In the first excitation states, this lone pair entering that set. That means a 6 oxidation state is there. Yet that means 600 electron will be taken. So what of them in this one? 1, 2, and P contain 3 orbitals and 5 electrons, and D contain 5 orbitals, 1 electron. Okay. Now here two. The remaining unpaired electrons are in the second excitation state. In S, it contains 1 orbital, 2 electron, and P contain 3 orbital and 4 electron, and D contain 5 orbital, 2 electron. So here basically what is 4 unpaired electron is there. Here 6 oxidation state is there. Simply 4 means now next goes to third excitation state. Yes, it contains 1, 2, and P contain 3 orbitals and 3 electrons, and D contain 5 orbitals, 3 electrons. Okay. Now in the previous topic, what happened? HCF2 means 2 fluorine, 2 unpaired, 2 oxidation state. HCF4 means 4 unpaired, 4 oxidation state, and 4 fluorine. HCF6 means 6 oxidation state, 6 fluorine. Okay, but here what happened? 3 oxygen, 6 oxidation state. So it is different. So in the third excitation state, there are 6 unpaired electrons. Out of 6 unpaired electrons, the first 3 unpaired electrons are sigma electrons. Other 3 unpaired electrons are pi electrons. Now sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. That's it. It undergoes sp3 hybridization. How many? 4 sp3. So pi electrons do not participate in hybridization. Now its shape of the molecule is cylinder. Xenon is the center metal. It is one lone pair of electron and 3 oxygen. 3 oxygen. 1, 2, 3. Its shape of the molecule is pyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is pyramidal. So in this one, first hybridization, how much? sp3 hybridization. Shape of the molecule, its shape of the molecule is pyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is pyramidal, and its oxidation state is plus 6. How many lone pair of electron here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lone pair. So lone pair only one. Bond pair is 6 bond pairs, and sigma electron is 3, sigma electron is here, sigma electron is 3 and pi electron is 3, pi electron also 3 and its bond angle is 107 degree. This XeO3 is a exclusive compound. XeO3 is a exclusive compound. This is xenon trioxide. What is xenon trioxide? In this xenon trioxide, xenon oxidation states are present. In this plastic means the plastics are present in the third hexagonal state. In the third hexagonal state, there are 6 unpaired electrons. Out of 6 unpaired electrons, the first 3 unpaired electrons are called sigma electrons. Other 3 unpaired electrons are called pi electrons. Sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. Pi electrons are they do not participate in hybridization. Now sp3 hybridization is formed, which means 4 equivalent hybrid order will be takes place. This XeO3 is a explosive compound. This sp3 undergoes, this XeO3 undergoes its automolecular distribution and its bond angle is 107 degrees. Its bond angle is 107 degrees. See XeO3. Now what are in the XeO4? Here see again XeO4. Now in this XeO4, first we find oxidation state. First we find oxidation state. What is the oxidation state here? X plus 4 into minus 2 equal to 0, x minus 8 equal to 0, then x equal to what are we? 8. 8 means 8 unpaired electron will be takes place. Now 8 unpaired electron, see again here NH2 NP6. Now this is in the ground state. In the ground state, yes, it contains 1, 2 and 3 contain 3 orbitals and then 6 electrons. Now in the first hexagonal state, this lone pair enters in that side. That means its oxidation state is plus 8. Plus 8 means 8 unpaired electron will be takes place. In the ground state, there is no unpaired electron. Unpaired electrons are enters in first hexagonal state. Yes, it contains 1, 2 and P contain 3 orbitals, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The 100 electrons are present D orbital psi. Okay, now the second hexagonal state, yes, it contains 1, 2 and P contain 3 orbitals and 4 electrons and D contain 5 orbitals, 2 electrons. Now in the third hexagonal state, yes, it contains 1, 2, then P contains 1, 2, 3 and D contains how many? 3 orbitals, 5 orbitals, 3 electrons. Okay, now what are we doing here? 6 unpaired electrons is there. But here 6 means 6 oxidation state. But here how many oxidation state is there? 8. The remaining unpaired electrons are in the same 4th hexagonal state. That is simply, this is 4th hexagonal state. So what is here? In S, it contains only 1. P contains 1, 2, 3. And D contains 5 orbitals, 4 electrons. 5 orbitals, 4 electrons. Now, listen. So here what is 8 unpaired electrons? So 8 oxidation state, 8 unpaired electrons. But here what are there? 4 oxidation state. That means in the 4th hexagonal state, there are 8 unpaired electrons. Out of 8 unpaired electrons, the first 4 unpaired electrons are called sigma electrons. Other 4 unpaired electrons are called pi electrons. Sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. Pi electrons are they do not participating in hybridization. Now sp3 hybridization is formed, which means 4 equivalent hybrid order will be takes place. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahedral. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahedral. How are the structure of tetrahedral? Xenon 1, 2, 3, 4. These are contain, all contain oxygen. That is, oxygen contain double bond. Oxygen contain double bond. So that means its shape of the molecule is what happened? Tetrahedral. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahydral. So here tetrahydral means, now see, first hybridization. What is hybridization? sp3, shape of the molecule. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahydral. Its shape of the molecule is tetrahydral. Then oxidation state. Its oxidation state is +8. Lone pair. Here lone pair, what happened? 1, 2. Lone pair is 0. Lone pair is 0. Bond pair. Bond pair amounts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bond pair is 8. Next, sigma electrons. How many sigma? 4. 5. How many? 4. Bond angle. It is 109°28' 109°28'. This is HCO4, xenon tetroxide. What is xenon tetroxide? In xenon tetroxide, its oxidation states are +8. In the fourth hexagonal state, there are 8 unpaired electrons. Out of 8 unpaired electrons, the first 4 unpaired electrons are called sigma electrons. Other 4 unpaired electrons are called pi electrons. Sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. Pi electrons are, they do not participate in hybridization. Now sp3 hybridization is formed, which means 4 equivalent hybridization takes place. So this is HCO4 is a tetrahedral shape. Instead, that means these sp3, these HCO3 is undergoes HCO3 undergoes sp3 hybridization. HCO4 also undergoes sp3 hybridization. What happened? Due to it is pyramidal, it is tetrahedral. What is the difference? Due to presence of lone pair of electron, due to absence of lone pair of electron. That's why it is a tetrahedral. It is a pyramidal. It is a tetrahedral. Instead of its bond angle is 107°, here 109°28'. Its bond angle is 109°28'. This is xenon oxides. Then now let us discuss xenon oxyhalides. These xenon oxyhalides are again three types. That is HCOF4, HCOF2, HCO2F2. Now we have to discuss one by one. Now HCOF4. So this is little bit difficult. So compared to halides and oxides, so xenon oxyhalides are little bit difficult to compare to halides and oxides. Now first, of course, we have to find oxidation state. What is oxidation state here? x+-2+4(-1)=0. x-2-4=0. X equal to what happened? 6. Directly x equal to 6. Here x equal to 6 means 6 unpaired electrons are which hexagonal states? Directly third hexagonal state. Now you have to write directly third hexagonal state. Now in this one here, third hexagonal state, what happened? Yes, it contains 1 orbital, 2 electron, and p contains 3 orbitals and 3 unpaired electrons, and d contains 5 orbitals and 3 electrons. 5 orbitals and 3 electrons. Now what we observe here, see, so in this one, how many fluorine? 4 fluorine. That means starting to 400 electron will be taken. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. How many oxygen? 1 oxygen. 1 oxygen nothing but 2 unpaired. These 2 are oxygen. These 2 are oxygen. If oxygen is there, 1 sigma, 1 pi electron will be formed. So this is sigma, this is pi. This is pi. We already discussed what are the pi electrons are, they do not participate in hybridization. So what is in this one? It undergoes sp3d2. It undergoes sp3d2. How many d2 5 total? 6 sp3d2 hybrid orbitals formed. These 6 sp3d2 hybrid orbitals undergoes square pyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is square pyramidal. So how does that square pyramidal? that square mean this is square. This is xenon. This is square. This is square. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are all of fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4. One oxygen is there. So one lone pair electron. This is pyramid. One oxygen is there. That is double bond. Its shape of the molecule is square pyramid. So this is HCOFO. What is HCOFO? See again. Here fluorine HCOFO. Oxygen oxidation state is -2. Fluorine oxidation state is -1. That's why its oxidation state what happened? Its oxidation state is 6. That 6 oxidation state means 6 unpaired electron will be displaced. 6 unpaired electron which excitation state is directly third excitation state. You know 4 fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's why 4 fluorine. How many oxygen? 1 oxygen. 1 oxygen thing but sigma electron by electron will be formed. So the last 2 unpaired electrons are sigma. One sigma, one unpaired. Pi electrons are they do not participate in hybridization. Now you can propose sp3d2 hybridization is formed. Which means total 6. So its shape of the molecule is square pyramid. At the same time, so its shape of the molecule is square pyramid. Next one, HCOF2. After HCOF4, next goes to HCOF2. What is HCOF2? See. HCOF2. Here HCOF2 means it is one. HCOF2 first we find oxidation state. First we find oxidation state. What is oxidation state for here? This is X plus minus 2 plus 2 into minus 1 equal to 0. X minus 2 minus 2 equal to 0. X minus 4 equal to 0. X equal to 4. X equal to 4. Now 4 unpaired electrons are which excitation states? Directly second excitation state. 4 unpaired electrons are directly second excitation state. Now you have to write directly second excitation state. So what is the second excitation state? Yes, it contains 1, 2 and P contains 3 orbitals. And how many electrons? 4 electrons. And D contain 5 orbitals. And how many electrons? 2 electrons. Okay, now 4 unpaired electrons are there. In the 4 unpaired electrons, here oxidation states also 4. Here oxidation states also 4. Now 4 unpaired electrons. But what happened here? How many fluorine? 2. 2 means 2 unpaired electrons. These 2 are fluorine. These 2 are fluorine. How many oxygen? 1 oxygen. 1 oxygen nothing but what happened? 1 sigma, 1 pi. So this is oxygen. These 2 are what happened? Oxygen. So this is sigma. This is pi. So we already discussed sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. Pi electrons are, they do not participate in hybridization. Sigma electrons are participating in hybridization. Pi electrons are, they do not participate in hybridization. That's why its shape of the molecule is trigonal. It undergoes sp3 dehybridization. It undergoes sp3 dehybridization. How many? 5. Its shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. So how draw the structure of trigonal bipyramidal? Here xenon is the center metal. How many fluorine? 2 fluorine. So this is 1 fluorine. This is second fluorine. 1 oxygen, that is double bond O, and 2 paired electron. This is 1 and this is 2. This is trigonal bipyramidal. This is HCOF2. What happened in the HCOF2? So this is HCOF2. In this HCOF2, its oxidation states are 4. Its 4 means the 4 unpaired electrons are in the second excitation state. The second excitation state, there are 4 unpaired electrons. In these 4 unpaired sigma electrons are participating in hybridization, pi electrons are did not participating in hybridization. That's why it undergoes sp3d hybridization is formed. It shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. The structure of the molecule is this one. The shape of the molecule, the structure is this one. Next, last one, that is XeO2F2. XeO2F2. What is first? Of course, we have to find oxidation state. X plus 2 into -2. 2 into -2 plus 2 into -1 equal to 0. Okay. Then what is here? X minus 4 minus 2 equal to 0. Of course. Then X minus 6 equal to 0. What happened here? X equal to 6. Now, in these 6 means, 6 unpaired electrons are which excitation state directly in the third excitation state. Now, you have to write directly here third excitation state. As how much it contain? 1. Now, here, directly third excitation state. Now, here, directly third one. See. Okay, third excitation state. In this third excitation state, yes, it contains here only 1 and 2, and P contains 3 orbitals and how many? 3 electrons. Okay, there is no problem. And D contains 5 orbitals and 3 electrons. Okay, 3 electrons. So here how many? 6. Here oxidation states also 6. But what happened? How many fluorine? 2. 2 fluorine means, 2 fluorine means starting to 2 unpaired. Okay. How many oxygen? 4. 4 oxygen nothing but what happened? This 4, this 2 oxygen is there. 2 oxygen nothing but 4 unpaired electrons. Out of 4 unpaired electrons, the first 2 sigma for oxygen, other 2 are pi. These pi electrons are they do not participate in hybridization. Okay. That's why what is the reason here? sp3d. It undergoes sp3d hybridization. How many? This is 3, this one 4, this total 5. Total 5 sp3d hybrid order is formed. Of course, here also sp3d, here also sp3d. But its shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. Its shape of the molecule is distorted trigonal bipyramidal. Distorted trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal due to presence of lone pair of electron. How the structure of this one? Xenon is the central metal. How many fluorine? 2 fluorine. So this is 1 double bond. O here double bond. Okay, 2 fluorine nothing but this is fluorine. This one also fluorine. How many paired electron? 1. This is, that's why this is distorted trigonal bipyramidal. This is completely xenon compounds. Completely xenon compound. So we can touch this just boundaries. Its oxidation states are 2, its oxidation state 4, its oxidation state is 6. It undergoes sp3d, it undergoes sp3d2, it undergoes sp3d3. It's XeO3, XeO4. Its oxidation state 6, its oxidation state is 8, already discussed. XeOF4, its oxidation state what happened? 6. XeOF2, its oxidation state 4, it is 6. So, of course, this is completely xenon compound. After the xenon compound, we have to discuss chemical properties of this xenon compounds. So, after the xenon oxyhalides, next topic is goes to preparation and properties of xenon compounds. Preparation and properties. See, preparation and properties. Now, we have to compulsorily remember that where, what are there in the xenon halides, xenon oxide halides. Preparation and properties are dependent upon that compound. See, for example, first one is xenon halides. See, xenon react to fluorine. Okay, that is xenon difluoride. Xenon react to fluorine. Get what happened? Xenon difluoride. Next, what is this? Is methods of preparation of xenon difluoride. Next is xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon react to 2 moles of fluorine to get xenon tetrafluoride. So that means xenon difluoride and propose hydrolysis, xenon tetrafluoride and propose hydrolysis, xenon hexafluoride and propose hydrolysis. What happened we observed? First, xenon difluoride. Xenon difluoride is undergoes hydrolysis. Is undergoes hydrolysis if you take 2 moles to get xenon, that means 2 moles of xenon. Here, how many fluorine? This is fluorine 2. 2 to the 4. This is 4. Plus 4HF plus O2. 4HF plus O2. Next, xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes. Xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes hydrolysis. Look at what happens. See, xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes hydrolysis. Is undergoes hydrolysis. Of course, xenon difluoride is undergoes hydrolysis to get XeHFO2. At the same time, xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes hydrolysis also same thing. Xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes hydrolysis also same thing. But here 6 moles, here 12 moles. 6 moles and 12 moles to get what are we see here. How many xenon is here? So xenon difluoride is undergoes hydrolysis to get xenon HF plus O2. Okay. Then xenon tetrafluoride undergoes hydrolysis to get, of course, XeHFO2. 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 By addition of byproduct, this is what happened? Xenon trioxide. Then xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes O2F2 to get XeF6 plus O2. Okay. Now, next one. Xenon hexafluoride, it is very very important. Xenon hexafluoride is undergoes hydrolysis. H2O. Okay. Now, here how many oxygen is there? One oxygen there, XeOF4. Now you have to write one over here. XeOF4. XeOF4. Now here, out of 6, 2 fluoride is there. The remaining one, only 2 fluorine. That's right. Plus 2 HF. Okay, next again XeF6. Now in case here 2H2, how many oxygen here? 2. That's a 2% there. XeO2F2. XeO2F2. Then how many fluorine here? 4. How many oxygen? 4. How many fluorine? 4. That's way. 4HF. Okay. The next, xenon hexafluoride, XeF6, plus now here 3 moles. 3 moles of oxygen where only one compound, that's XeO2. That's right here, XeO3 plus XeO3. The remaining 6 hydrogen plus 6 HF. This is chemical properties of xenon compounds. The next, one more is there. Xenon difluoride, they have to pass the pentafluoride. Next one. Xenon difluoride react to phosphorus pentafluoride to get cationic and anionic species is formed. That means HCF minus, HCF minus plus PF6 plus, PF6 plus. That means when, so in this one here HCF minus PF6 plus. In this one, what happened we observed? Here, xenon difluoride gives phosphorus pentafluoride to get HCF2 plus and PF6 minus. At the same time, xenon tetrafluoride is undergoes, this replace SBFR. SBFR to get what happened here? HCF3 plus and SB, how many here total? 9. Out of 9, 3 is there. Then SB F6 minus. Next, the same thing. Xenon hexafluoride. Xenon hexafluoride react to KF. React to KF. To get what happened? XeF5 plus and KF6 minus. That means xenon difluoride, tetrafluoride, hexafluoride is undergoes form. So this is xenon compound. So next, after that, general physical properties of this one. Physical properties of noble gas. Here, noble gas remains melting point. Noble gas elements of melting point is very low. Noble gas elements melting point is low. And boiling point is also low. Boiling point is also low. That means simply noble gas elements melting point boiling point is very low. Noble gas elements melting point boiling point is very low. Due to what happened? Due to weak intermolecular attractive force. Then ionization potential. Both same. Melting point, boiling point of noble gas is very low due to weak intermolecular attractive force between them. That's why this melting point, boiling point are very low. Next, ionization potential. Basically, ionization potential. The ionization potential of noble gas is very high. The ionization potential of noble gas elements is very high due to stable electronic configuration. Due to stable electronic configuration. Next, electron affinity. Noble gas of electron affinity becomes zero. Due to it is also stable electronic configuration. This is completely noble gas elements. So what happens in this melting point? Noble gas elements of melting point boiling point is very low. Due to what happened? Weak intramolecular force of attraction, ionization potentials of noble gas elements are very high due to stable electronic configuration and indifferent to remove of electron. So electron affinity means the amount of energy is released when an electron is added. Neutral isolated gases atom are called electron affinity. The noble gas element electron affinity becomes zero due to stable electronic configuration. This is what are then completely noble gas elements. So now in this second year chemistry, so seventh group element we already discussed. And noble gas elements, this is noble gas elements. Of course, this one also already discussed. Due to some technical problem, we have to discuss again. So this is noble gas elements. So we can touch all topic in this noble gas elements up to starting to. So first, what is the noble gas elements? Noble gas elements means they have completely filled valence cell with electronic configuration are called noble gas elements. Noble gas elements are helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. All elements are monoatomic gas elements. So here, helium is the gas, radon is the radioactive elements, and after that, xenon compound HCF2, HCF4, HCF6. It is plus 2, plus 4, plus 6. sp3d2, sp3d3. It is linear, square pyramidal, destroyed octahedral. XeO3 plus 6, XeO4 plus 8. XeO3 is the pyramidal, XeO4 is the tetrahedral. XeO4 is the sp3 hybridization. XeO4 is the sp3d2. This is sp3d. How can the form oxidation state? What is the shape of the molecule? How many bond pair? How many lone pair? We already discussed in this one. After that, how prepare that the xenon nitrate? Xenon react with fluorine to get xenon nitrate. It is in the 2:1 ratio. Xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon react with 2 moles of fluorine to get xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon react with 3 moles of fluorine to get xenon hexafluoride. Then undergoes chemical properties. What are the chemical properties? Undergoes hydrolysis. Xenon nitrofluoride undergoes hydrolysis to get XeHF4O2. In tetrafluoride is also same thing. XeHF4O2 and XeO3 is the additional product. Xenon tetrafluoride undergoes O2F2 to get XeF6 plus OF4O2. These three are xenon dihexafluoride. These three undergoes xenon hexafluoride chemical properties. Here only one oxygen. magnesium difluoride, we have to pentafluoride compound. Okay, cationic and anionic species will be formed. After that, few chemical properties, physical properties of this one. Melting point of noble gas elements becomes zero, and boiling point of noble gas becomes zero due to weak intermolecular attraction between them. Ionization potential. Ionization potentials of noble gas elements are very high due to stable electronic configuration. It cannot be removed electrons. And electron affinity. Electron affinity means the amount of energy released when an electron is added. Neutral isolated gases atom are called electron affinity. So noble gas elements electron affinity becomes zero due to stable electronic configuration. So this is completely noble gas elements. This is completely noble gas elements. Then next to tomorrow we discuss, next class we have to discuss sixth group elements. So this is noble gas elements. Okay, thank you guys.